finally, Biollante, the mean green Godzilla plant herself. She looks beautiful, doesn't she? So to start things off fresh, let's take a look inside Biollante's mouth. Now on the roof of her mouth, you can see that she's got those tiny little teeth that she had in the movie. Pretty sure the original had teeth inside of the mouth as well, just stating that they're there, as well as some paint dribble. And those little mini seed-looking teeth are present on the bottom of the mouth as well. Moving down to Biollante's stomach, we can see that the orange is there, and there are some nice squigglies in there. It looks really, really nice. And we can also admire the detail of Biollante's base. Vines and thorns. Looking fantastic. Moving over to the side of the head, we can see that the teeth are painted rather nicely, aside from some dribble and not great paint bleeding over here. I really like the paint that they used on Biollante's eye. It's like this metallic pinkish gray. Looks awesome. Pulling out a little bit, you can see that the varying green doesn't stop at the base of Biollante's neck. It goes all the way to the top. And here we have a picture of Biollante's vine. The paint on the teeth came out a lot better than I expected it to be. And the detail over here is pretty nice as well. Moving on to the vine on Biollante's back, this one has its mouth opened, but it is not painted for whatever reason. You can see some really great veins and thorns on Biollante's side over here, and the tree bark-esque lines that they put on this vine looks absolutely stunning. It looks great! I just wish they would have painted the teeth in the mouth, but beggar can't be chooser, I guess. Moving on to Biollante's back, you can see that varying green I mentioned earlier carries all the way to her backside, and it looks fantastic. The detail on these dorsal leaves is just utterly supreme. And let's check out the tag. We've got a very ghastly image of Biollante on the front, while on the back we have her dorsal leaves and one of the vines with its mouth slightly askew. And here we're looking at the other back vine with its mouth opened, no inner mouth painted or teeth, but yet again, thorns, vines, the detail, utterly fantastic. Here is a shot of the other vine that Biollante has. Yet again, we got great detail on the vine itself, some good paint on the teeth, and moving over to the side of Biollante's head, we run into the one major problem. There is red paint all over her mouth, from her teeth over here to the top over there, and some paint bleeding over here. Why is there paint dribble over here? Why? I really don't understand why, but it's there, and it's rather unruly. Although that metallic paint on the eyes does look fantastic. And on the bottom we get trademark and copyright Toho Company Limited Bondi 2017 China and a bunch of numbers and a little hole on Biollante's other side showing that she is hollow. Biollante all around looks fantastic. If it wasn't for that paint dribble, it would look even better. I do really wish that the vines in the back were painted, teeth and inner mouth and all, but overall I got the varying green on the base of Biollante's neck all the way to her backside. We got great paint in the mouth and on the teeth here and there. And overall, this Biollante figure looks great. Now, when it comes to the articulation with Biollante's new figure, you really don't get much, but I was expecting that since this is essentially just a hollow piece of vinyl. You'll be able to move the vines all the way around, just like so, and you'll be able to move Biollante's head all the way around. The two vine mouths on the back of Biollante don't move. I mean, they do this, but that is because this is a very soft vinyl figure. But aside from the limited articulation and such, you do get great detail, decent paint applications, at least on mine, and overall, this is the Biollante figure I was hoping for. Just the right size, great amount of detail. The paint could have been a little better in some places, but that's just mine. Overall, I'm happy with this Biollante figure. Let's end this review off with a size comparison. Here is the new Biollante figure next to the reissued Destroya and Mecha King Ghidorah. As you can see, she is much smaller, but when it comes down to how wide Biollante is, she is definitely going to be a shelf hog. But thankfully, the vines are articulated, so you can squeeze her in a few places. Here is Biollante next to the Godzilla GMK 9-inch Bandai figure and the Godzilla Earth figure. And here is the new Biollante figure next to the new Mecha Godzilla figure. Ooh! Review coming today. Now, when it comes to Biollante, I can't recommend the figure enough. We're finally getting a new Biollante figure after years of not having a reissue, and in all honesty, the wait was worth it. I'm just a little upset that mine has some paint dribble on it, but as far as scoring the figure overall, highest recommend. Just don't be surprised if yours comes with some paint dribble. Now, since I lack the original Biollante figure, I really can't compare the two, but like I said in my size comparison, She's gonna take up a lot of room, and that's what I was hoping for. I didn't want a downsized Biollante, and if the original figure is bigger than this, then I think I should really get the original figure as well. But anyway, those are my thoughts and opinions on the Bandai Movie Monster Series Biollante reissue. Please comment down below, tell me what your feelings are towards the figure, let me know if you're gonna pick one up or if you're currently awaiting one to come in the mail, and I will see you all next time. Bye, everybody.